Hey, second graders, Mrs. Cole here, kicking off Poetry Week with you with haikus, poetry that comes from the land of the rising sun, Japan. So let's go ahead and hop right on into our PowerPoint for it. As I said, we are studying haikus for today. Now down here, I have it written 575. I'm not sure if you know what those numbers are for yet, but you will learn soon enough. So try to keep them in your head, okay? Haikus, as I had said before, are from Japan. So they're a form of Japanese poetry that have three lines. So when you write it out, it has three lines literally written out. Haikus are based on syllables. If you're not sure what a syllable is, syllables are the beats of a word. So we're gonna go ahead and try finding some syllables for the following words: cat, muffin, February, and bamboo. When we're finding the syllables, we want to kind of feel in our mouth when we're closing our mouth again, because that's the end of a syllable. So for example, we'll say the word cat. So just say cat normal, cat, then say it a little slower, cat. And when your mouth closes again, that's your one syllable, and you'll clap for your one syllable. So cat, cat, cat. Cat is one syllable because I opened my mouth to say it and I only closed my mouth one time before I finished the word. Let's try it again here with the word muffin. So say the word muffin and then we'll say it slowly and kind of break it up. Muffin, 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 muffin. We'll throw the claps in there too. Muffin. Muff. Here I am closing my mouth to finish the word. So that's muffin. That's two syllables there. Muffin. All right. Here's a kind of challenging one. February. We'll say it slow. We'll say it normal and then we'll say it slow. February. 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 This is the first one. And then I'm closing my mouth on the B. Bew. And then I'm switching sounds to the A. Air. And then I'm closing my mouth for the R a little bit and saying the Y. E. February. February. Last one. This one's not as hard. The word's bamboo. So we'll say it fast or regular, and then we'll say it slow. Bamboo. Pretty easy. Bamboo. 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 There we go. It's got two syllables. Syllables are a little bit difficult. They're a little challenging, but they make more sense as you play with it more, okay? So don't give up. So as we had said before, haikus have three lines. Each of the lines has a different number of beats or syllables. The first line has five beats. The second line has seven beats. And the last line has five beats again. Did we hear that somewhere before? Five, seven, five. Yeah, that's the number that we saw written out at the beginning. The 5-7-5. 5, 7, 5. That's how you remember how many syllables go into each one of the lines for a haiku. So let's try counting the beats for the next few haikus that we're going to look at. This haiku is called rain. And that kanji there, that's the Japanese character. It says ame, which means rain in Japanese. The haiku says, splish, splash, puddle, bath. Raindrops march in spring parade. Wake up, sleepy earth. Okay, none of that rhymes. So how can that be a poem? Well, like we said before, haikus are not based on rhyming. They're based on syllables. So let's count the syllables in the first line. And then we'll count the syllables in the second line. And then again in the third line. So in that first line, let's count them together, okay? Here we go. Splish, splash, puddle, bath. So splish, splash, Puddle bath. You should have gotten 5 syllables. Remember, we're feeling for when our mouth closes and when there's a good break in the word as we're reading it. Okay, next line. We're looking for 7 syllables. Raindrops march in spring parade. Raindrops march in spring parade. Did you get 7? Because you should have. Okay, here we go again. Last line, we should have 5 syllables. Wake up, sleepy earth. I forgot to clap. Let's do it again. Wake up, sleepy earth. Wake up, sleepy earth. Did you get 5 syllables? There's that pattern again, that number that we wrote out, 5, 7, 5. That is the essence of haiku. All right, let's try it again with this other one. This poem or this haiku is called Snow. In Japanese, the kanji here that's written says yuki. So yuki is snow in Japanese. It says, high on mountaintop, hippo watches snowflakes dance. Winter has begun. So notice this poem is different from the last one because this poem is talking about the title. It's talking about rain. This poem is not talking about rain. It's talking about snow. So the title has something to do with what the poem actually says. All right, here we go. Counting them out. High on mountain top. High on mountain top. High on mountain top. There's 5. Hippo watches snowflakes dance. Hippo watches snowflakes dance. Hippo watches snowflakes dance. There's our 7. Winter has begun. Winter has begun. Winter has begun. 5. Very good. There's that 5, 7, 5 again. Remember, when we're feeling for the syllables, usually it's when your mouth is closing or it touches or it does something to kind of cut off the sound. All right, this last poem is called Flower. The kanji that's written here in Japanese, it says hana. Hana means flower. The poem says, in tickly toe grass, a buttercup offers up yellow nose kisses. This haiku is about a flower, which is exactly what the title is. It's talking about a buttercup. That's the type of flower. As you can see right here, where the little deer is sniffing. Okay, time to count. Ready? Here we go. In tickly toe grass, in tickly toe grass. Sorry, I messed that up. In tickly toe, oh no, I didn't. In tickly toe grass. There we go. Sorry, Mrs. Cole's getting all confused. Oh, in tickly toe grass, a buttercup offers up. A buttercup offers up. A buttercup offers up. 7. So we had 5, 7. Yellow nose kisses. Yellow nose kisses. Yellow nose kisses. Yellow nose kisses. So kisses is split up because when you say the S in kiss, your mouth is closing a little bit. And then the E, S, for the plural is adds your other syllable. So yellow nose kisses. Very good. 5, 7, 5 again. Now let's try it out ourselves. All right. This is where you are going to need to go ahead and pull out your haiku packet. It has 3 pages. One has a haiku on the front. The next one has a form for you to fill out. And the last one has a final draft page. So go ahead and find this packet and come on back. Okay. So you have your packet in front of you. And as we have already read before, haiku is a form of Japanese poetry that has three lines. The first and the last lines have five syllables, and the middle, or line number two, has seven syllables. The poems don't usually rhyme. So here's another example of a haiku. Listen carefully, and then we'll answer the questions down here. It says, butterfly above, sitting on a pink flower, sipping sweet nectar. Here we go. I'm going to clap it out for you. Butterfly above, sitting on a pink flower, sipping sweet nectar. Okay. In this poem, in this haiku, what are two things that the butterfly is doing? Go ahead and take a second to write that down. What are two things that this butterfly is doing? Where is the butterfly? That's your next question here. Write down where the butterfly is on your line. So, butterfly above, sitting on a pink flower, sipping sweet nectar. What are two things he's doing? And what's one thing about where the butterfly is? How do you know that this poem's a haiku? Well, that one's pretty easy, right? Because we clapped it out. We were able to figure out that each line matches the 5-7-5 syllable pattern that all haikus have. Okay, so once you've filled all that out, we are going to create our own haikus. Woo! So just like with the other ones that we were reading, where it was about ame, or rain, yuki, or snow, and hana, or flowers, we are going to come up with our own haiku based off of something, a topic. So choose the topic you would like to write about. It could be a food, it could be a color, it could be a game that you like, it could be a person that you like, it could be anything. Now you're going to use five syllables to describe the topic and what it does. So for example, if my topic was a color, I could actually just list out things that are that color. So if I had the color yellow as my topic, I could say sunshine and daisies or something like that. As I'm saying the words, I need to practice clapping out my syllables. Then, once you've gone ahead and you've gotten your first line done, write your second line, the seven syllables. Describe some more what's going on with your topic. Then on your last line, you're going to go back to five syllables to describe the topic again. Once you've written all this out, you are going to double check your work, make sure each of your lines has five syllables or seven syllables, depending on which line it's supposed to be. And then you're going to write a really nice copy of it right here. So you'll put your title here at the top. You're going to put your first line from this page over here, your second line from this page, where it's seven syllables right here, and then your last line, the last five syllables here, over here, and you're going to write your name. There's a lot of open space on this page too, so please feel free to draw around your words or to color in around your words to complement your haiku. So put in a good illustration. Give us a good visualization of what it is you wrote your haiku about. Once you've finished doing that, go ahead and share it with a friend, share it with a family member. You can even take a picture of it and send it in to your teacher. Okay, second graders, if you need a little bit of inspiration or some help with trying to figure out the syllables, I have some friends here from Blazer Fresh, Go Noodle, that have a song for you to figure out how to find the syllables of words. It's called Clap It Out. Enjoy, and I'll see you next time.
Clap it out. Syllables. boost and the syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. We be miserable without syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. Count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. Mice, mice, bake, bake. Cheese, cheese, cakes, cakes. Put it all together now. Mice, bake, cheese, cakes.
One more time.
Mice, bake, cheese, cakes. I guess a mouse would bake a cheesecake, right? Syllables, this is syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. We be miserable without syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. Count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
Two syllables. Let's do it.
Awesome. Awesome. Hamster. Hamster. Birthday. Birthday. Party. Party. Put it together now. Awesome. Hamster. Birthday party.
One more time.
Awesome. Hamster. Birthday party.
That was a crazy party.
Syllables. It's the syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. We be miserable without syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart.
Come on.
Count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
Three syllables. Work it out.
Woo. Chimpanzee, chimpanzee. Volunteers, volunteers. Inspecting, inspecting. Chandeliers, chandeliers. Put it all together now. Chimpanzee, volunteers. Inspecting, chandeliers.
One more time.
Chimpanzee, volunteers. Inspecting, chandeliers.
I can see everything in here now.
Syllables, this is syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. We be miserable without syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. Count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
Four syllables get complex.
Invisible, invisible. Alligators, alligators. Appreciate, appreciate. Calculators, calculators. Put it all together now. Invisible, alligators. Appreciate, calculators.
One more time.
Invisible, alligators. Appreciate, calculators. Syllables, this is syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. We be miserable without syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. Count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
Five syllables, blow it up.
Vegetarian, vegetarian. Hippopotamus, hippopotamus. Evaluating, evaluating. Potato salad, put it all together now. Vegetarian, hippopotamus, evaluating potato salad.
One more time.
Vegetarian, hippopotamus, evaluating potato salad.
My evaluation of this potato salad is really great.
Syllables, this is syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. We be miserable without syllables. They're what you get when you take a word apart. Count, count, count some syllables. Clap it out, clap it out. This is how we rock with syllables. Clap it out, clap it out.
Syllables.
Yeah, my mom's potato salad's better than your mom's.
Not really, but we'll see.